Okay, today I want to discuss with you the big controversy that's going with dryers. This is a 120 volt dryer, or 110 volt, plugs into a regular 110 outlet. Okay, and there's dryers that are made with a 240 volt outlet. So what's the difference? Well, what it is the manufacturers are able to reduce costs on the dryer by putting in a 220 volt dryer. The reason? The amount of copper that's in the winding of the copper motors. It takes a lot more copper to wrap the windings of a 110 motor. So for a 220 motor, you have a lot less copper wrapped in one of the windings because you can get the drive power out of the 220 voltage. So a little bit different. 220 is not necessarily better or faster drying. You still have your regular coils on the back here. It's only how the dryer motor is able to spin. Still spins the same way. Heat is still exactly the same. All it is the spinning of the motor. So once again, the difference, the 110 voltage, the dryer motor, the coils around the motor will be more windings, more copper windings, so the copper adding the cost to the dryer itself. So a 220 volt dryer is cheaper. And that's the story on 220 versus 110 dryers. Of course, 220 dryers will be wired different and you'll need a different plug, larger plug outlet for the 220 volt. And not every situation is run for that. Mine's not, although I do have empty slots in my breaker panel that I can take out here to add, you know, the larger 220 breaker for dryer. As you can see, mine's 110 right now. Not in any hurry to change that, really, because again, it just reduces the cost of the machine itself, but doesn't really improve in efficiency or anything. Still got the same heater coil, same amount of heat output, just different in the way that it rotates.